ओके, सो कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन साहित फॉर सक्सेसफुली क्लियरिंग मल्टीपल इंटरव्यूज. कैन यू टेल अस इन विच ऑल कंपनीज यू हैव गॉट ऑफर लेटर्स एंड व्हाट वाज द टाइम पीरियड दैट यू टुक फॉर क्लियरिंग द इंटरव्यूज?
Thank you. Thanks, Rakesh. And I would say, like, platforms like your channel and all other community have helped me a lot to gain my knowledge in all these areas that I was a bit lagging. So when coming to the offers which I got, actually, I have been planning to switch because of huge demand that I've created in the recent days. So just I thought to give a try and started for preparations. So one company which I've got offer is from TCS actually. So there I was very much interested to join with a big organization, but I couldn't join there because of the role that I got from there was not that challenging or not that interested for me. And and again I was trying for the better opportunities. And I also got an offer from another startup company, Noida based it is. So there I took their offer and put my resignation initially. So the preparation was started on Java initially. Because I have found or I have realized that most of the interviews are judging based on my programming skills rather than the tool knowledge or the experience of roles and responsibilities that I was working on. So, and I was also need to improve it there. So most of the preparation was done on programming language, basically Java. So I have brushed up my initial core Java concepts firstly. Then I have mostly concentrated on collection frameworks, basically, that are asked repeatedly in interviews. So once I was clear about the basic concepts, then I started to apply those knowledge on some of the real-time coding challenge like logics that are repeatedly asked, like as you have said, string manipulations or array concepts and all on the on those I have tried these topics initially and practiced a bit more. Then obviously some of the tricky questions that ask in Selenium or else rest assured with the predefined functions and all. So all those sort of preparation was done, and yeah, that's it.
Right. That's quite insightful. Okay, so how many companies did you apply in a day? Let's say when you are looking for a new job or new job opportunity. So in a day, you might be spending time on applying for the job. You might be having work as well, Monday to Friday. We all are overloaded with our current projects and current company. So how did you take out time to apply to those companies, and how many companies did you apply?
Basically, I will apply most. I don't count those, but firstly, I'll check the job description and the preferred location. If the job description is a bit challenging, and then I'll give a try. At this time only, I won't go into company profiles and start looking their reviews and all, because either we get an offer or else we get to learn something new from these each and every interviews. So I'll just look at the JD and the job description is matching for my my preferred. So I started applying. So here my suggestion would be there would be some perk services provided by each of these job portals. So they won't charge much, but we will get good responses from there. So the charge would be something like 2,000 or 4,000 per 3 months quarterly, but the responses that we get from these services is like tremendous. So that approach I would suggest in case if someone really trying for their jobs and all. Yeah, basically most of the companies may reject because of you know the joining date that they were looking and I have. So in those cases we can't do anything, but once a technical round was put, then that time like I'll do some preparations and you know based on that I'll give the interviews. So generally there will be some you know technical round. And then the second technical round, wherein in this first technical and second technical, they will ask usually to share my screen and they'll try to give me some logic and they'll try to, you know, analyze my analytical skills, how I'm going to approach. So what I have observed is for some of the interviews, if they have given some, you know, beginner or intermediate coding, I sort of try to finish that. In case if they give me some advanced logical, even though I have tried to solve that, and if I you know tell them the logic which I was going to put to solve this solution, then also like those rounds got cleared. So basically, what I got understood is they were looking the logical part. How am I going to solve those challenge? So if they got convinced with that, then they were taking my profile to the next level. So that was one thing that I have observed.
Right. So it is very right. So most of the companies, you know, the hiring managers, they look for the approach or the logic that you will go for rather than just making you write the entire program. So even if you tell them the logic, so syntax errors are absolutely fine. You tell them about the logic, you have that clarity, then definitely they'll be happy with the profile, with your profile. Okay. So how many total offer letters you have got so far?
So actually I've got two offer letters and you know based on those one offer letter I have put my resignation and now it's been around 25 days I have put my resignation and I've been looking for some better opportunity on that based on you know the demand that is being created outside. So now again, I got two more offer letters on like salary discussions were done. So I was waiting for, you know, the final confirmation mail. So yeah, though actually I'm from Hyderabad. So now I can, you know, judge a job with my location and some other constraints also rather than not technical. So that kind of opportunities or that kind of decisions now we can make because we have some better opportunity in hands for the safer side.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So when we start the job search, getting the first job is difficult. But once you get one of the offer letters, then automatically you start getting other offer letters because that confidence level comes up. And sometimes, you know, things start to move in the positive direction. So it has happened, yeah. You know, many a times I have been asking people. So they tell, I got one offer letter and then I got two or three other immediately. But getting the first offer letter, because before getting the first offer letter, you have to prepare well yourself. You will be revisiting all the concepts, all the
basics. That would be a bit harder part.
Right. That is the most difficult part actually. So once you are able to clear that particular for one company, then automatically your confidence level boosts up. And now you're also having an idea, okay, this is how questions will be coming.
Yeah, so that level of understanding will be more. But now and also my, you know, presentation skills in the interview will also be a bit, you know, better now. Initially, I was like hurry-burry and all at the time of answering. You know, result with this is for ourselves, you know, we will think that I have presented my interview well. But from the other sides, you know, they were not able to get, you know, the exact answer from our side. So this mismatch would be there. But now maybe, you know, I was trying to communicate with them clearly and also sort of that clarity got a bit improved. Now I can say.
Right.
And some confident level also a bit, you know, better now. Mm-hmm. So.
Right. So were you applying only for manual testing jobs or automation testing jobs or mix of both?
No, I was only looking for automation testing. It's not like that. I was only looking for automation because obviously, 30% or 40% or 20% based on their requirement, we have to be also involved in manual testing.
Naturally.
So that is what the role that I was looking into. So in case if I didn't get an offer or if I didn't get an opportunity to totally work with automation or only manual, then I was just rejecting those offers because that is what my interest into. Even though the salaries are a bit high or the organization is a bit well established, because now I can see bit more scope is there, and my personal interest is also a bit more into automation side. And most of the interviews that I have selected were, there were been screening candidates for those traditional frameworks like Selenium or APIs and all, but internally they were implementing some latest tools and technologies like the Chai Mocha sessions that you have mentioned, and Cypress also that they were trying to implement. So some sort of logical they were expecting and some proper knowledge on one tool or any of one programming languages. Based on that they were selecting the candidates. That is what I came to know. And I also started to look at some of the get to go kind of videos on each technology. Like it should not be totally new to us. What is the Cypress or what is what? So what some the names and what are the some basic differences between the frameworks that we are using or the tools like Selenium, Cypress, what are the difference, advantages, why people are going to those, and even Protractor. So all these some small sort of knowledge I was gaining and moving ahead.
Definitely. Yeah, that's too good. So thank you so much for sharing the success story with us, Sahith. It was pleasure having you on the YouTube channel, and I am sure that many people who are watching this video would get help from it. Okay. Anything you would like to add for the people who are looking for the job opportunities and testing? Any sort of preparation tips or tricks or anything from your side?
Like for freshers or for the people who are joining or yet to start their career into automation or testing, I would suggest them to don't sort of keep this mindset that once totally I complete every syllabus and everything, then only I'll start with the interviews. Sometimes this approach wouldn't work because we cannot complete the total syllabus somehow, because there are a lot of applications and devices that are there in when it comes to testing. People ask mobile, and if you start learning mobile, then again people ask performance even for the freshers. So I would suggest them to just start with the interview and keep on improving by interviewing only. And for the experienced, I would say like just plan some time, give some time, and schedule some time for the course, whole course, like programming language, some sort of 10 15 days initial and 1 week for one tool, something like that. Once the schedule is done, then they can start with the interviewing. And I would say most of my preparation was improved by giving interviews only.
Right,
So that approach I would suggest to.
Right. So giving mock interviews is also one of the key. And as you give interviews in other companies also, you'll come to know, okay, what level of questions are asked or how much is your preparation, is that at that par or not? So those things
Even
are
mock
very helpful.
interviews also, by looking at some of the mock interviews or giving all these opportunities that you have been created for us, it's very good actually.
Okay, thank you so much that these videos are actually useful to you. And once again, many, many congratulations to you for getting four job offer letters, and wishing you all the best in your career ahead. Yeah.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Rakesh.
Yeah,
Thank you.
thank you so much. Yes. Bye.